Now let us consider the second question. It is also of matching type. But in this case, in the last class, I have not mentioned about the principle of this. In qualitative analysis, there is one test known as flame test. This flame test usually gives an idea about the presence of some basic radicals, namely metallic ions. Of course, there are also one acid radical which is capable of giving a colored flame, which I will let you know. Now, in this flame test, what we normally do is we take a small amount of the given substance and make it into a paste with hydrochloric acid. Make it into a paste. And this paste is introduced into the flame of the Bunsen burner. Depending on the nature of the salt, don't think all the salts will give flame coloration. Only certain salts are capable of giving the characteristic flame color. For example, consider this. First one, brick red flame coloration. First column, the flame color. Second column, you have to match it to the corresponding metallic ions present. Brick red. Usually, calcium salts will give a brick red coloration in the flame test. So, for A, I give the answer here. A, brick red, corresponding to this calcium, namely B. All right, second one. There are certain salts, the cations of which will give an apple green flame coloration. Usually, apple green flame color is due to barium salts. Usually barium salts, probably you remember in the fireworks, in order to have some green coloration, we usually introduce barium salts. So for small b, D is the correct option, namely barium salt. Come to C. Brick red and crimson red, these two are quite different. During Deepavali season, you might have noticed these different colors in your firework. Green color, red color, crimson red color. This crimson red color is normally due to strontium salts. Even though it is not included in your textbooks, I want to mention one point. This crimson red flame coloration is given not only by strontium salts, but also by lithium salts. So, if lithium salt is given for analysis, the flame coloration is again crimson red. So, strontium and lithium salts will give this crimson red flame coloration. Next, golden yellow flame color. Usually, sodium salts will give this golden yellow flame coloration. Last one, E, violet flame color. Violet coloration is given by A, potassium salts. Now, in this connection, I want to mention some points. Of course, I have given the answers here. You can notice. Now, flame test in general gives an idea about the presence of metallic radicals. But these are not confirmatory tests. You have to perform some other chemical reactions which are known as confirmatory tests for confirming the presence of these metallic ions. Now, I have also mentioned one of the acid radicals, namely borate, BO3, 3 minus. This also gives a green edged flame. It is known as ethyl borate test. So, borate, if it is present in a salt, it will give a green edged flame. Do you follow? Now, let us consider question number 3. Here, again, there are certain reagents we are going to use. First column and second column, the corresponding formulae of these compounds. Now, in qualitative analysis, there is a test known as borax bead test. Borax bead test. Now, what is borax? Of course, you might have understood by now from the name itself, borax should contain boron in it. Consider column 2. D, Na2B4O7 10H2O. For one, I write the answer here. For one, D is the correct option. Borax is sodium borate, Na2B4O7 10H2O. All right. Next one, microcosmic salt test. Just like borax bead test, we have microcosmic salt test. Just like borax, what is this salt? Microcosmic salt. For two, microcosmic salt is C, the ammonium hydrogen phosphate. This is known as the microcosmic salt. All right. Now, before we proceed, I want to mention one point here. Borax bead test and microcosmic salt test, these two tests are utilized in qualitative analysis for colored salts. Please remember the first two compounds which are used in borax bead test and microcosmic salt test. Usually these two tests are performed only in the case of colored salts. Please remember this. You note down this point. Third one, Prussian blue. Now, in qualitative analysis, if ferric ion is present, for example, there are some tests like adding ammonium thiocyanate, for example, when you get blood red coloration. All right, but here, what is a Prussian blue? It is a blue precipitate. It is B, the iron complex. D, M, G. D, M, G. Dimethyl glyoxime. Please notice is to be given regarding the spelling. It is O-X-I-M-E, glyoxime, because there is a substance known as oxine, O-X-I-N-E, you should not confuse. D-M-G is dimethyl glyoxime. Immediately, you should remember, it is a reagent for finding out the presence of nickel. So, what is a D-M-G? DMG is E. This compound is known as dimethyl glyoxime, which will give a rosy red precipitate with nickel ion. All right. Last, sodium nitroprusside. You might have understood even in the last class I have mentioned this sodium nitroprusside is a reagent for sulfide radical. Say, If sodium sulfide is present, to this add sodium nitroprusside solution when you get a violet coloration. Sodium nitroprusside is A. You might have noticed A is a complex. A is a complex. The violet coloration, that is also another complex. That violet coloration is this count. For the sake of understanding, I give the violet compound is Na4FeCN5 times NOS. So I have given the answers here. You can notice